sitting on a feeling, breaking down the ceiling, taking out the deep end. Freezing on the beaches, which are for the sweetest, sweetest beaches. We won't live too long.
Drinking all week, baby, that's just fine. You've been stepping on me, baby, it's alright.
You've been tearing me apart in the dead of night. I'll be raising my hands and the lightning strikes. Working on a feeling, breaking down the ceiling, digging up the deep end. Freezing on the beaches, reaching for the sweetest, sweetest beaches. We won't live too long. So let's love. Freezing on the beaches, reaching for the sweetest, sweetest beaches.
This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. Each character in the tale is going to be represented by a different instrument of the orchestra. For example, Peter is represented by the strings. The bird will be played by the flute, which plays very, very high. The duck played by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet in a very low key. Peter's grandfather will be represented by the bassoon. The sometimes we hear the timpani or kettle drums. And there's also a wolf by the French horn. Went out into the big green meadow to capture the wolf. Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. "It is the dangerous place," he said. "If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do?" He then carried Peter back to the cabin. Peter still dreamed of hunting, though, and when his grandfather fell fast asleep, he slipped out. Sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Just then, a duck came waddling along. She saw the wolf when he wasn't actually there. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. It was a cat crawling through the grass. The little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to the duck, and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" said he. To this, the duck replied, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond and the little bird hopping along the shore. But everybody calmed down and began hunting the wolf once more. Thank you. had been watching the squabble from behind some trees. Suddenly, he darted out and began to chase the duck. As she ran back and forth, from this side to that, trying to get away. The others tried to help. Over there, they shouted, run for the hollow tree. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. A little green feather floated down to the snow, and that was all her friends could find of her. Would this crime go unpunished? Not if Peter and the bird could help it. Peter quickly made a lasso with his rope, and the bird threw it over the branch of a tree. Peter climbed up onto the branch and held on tightly to the other end of the rope. They didn't have long to wait. Soon the wolf came rushing into the clearing. He was in a hurry and didn't notice Peter's rope, and before the wolf knew what had happened, Peter had caught him by the tail and was holding on for dear life. Struggle, snapping its big teeth at the bird, who fluttered around trying to help Peter, who was pulling hard on the rope. The bird got so excited he even bumped into the tree. The rope, sawing back and forth against the branch, began to fray. Peter asked the bird to fly for help. Just when things were looking their darkest, Peter heard a hunting horn and looked down. It was the hunters. The bird had brought help at last. By the time the hunters reached Peter, he had the cat, or he and the cat already have the wolf tied up. So Peter was a hero and they were safe. They tied the wolf to a pole and paraded him through the town, and all the villagers cheered. The bird wasn't happy, though. He was thinking of the duck, his lost playmate. But when he went back to the hollow tree, there was the duck, who had hidden inside and was safe after all. So now, Peter could go hunting whenever he wanted to, and everybody lived happily ever after. Everybody, that is, except for the wolf.